Liverpool Man United. I really do expect this to be a high-scoring game. I think both teams are going to go for it. I expect Man United to be hitting Liverpool easily on the counter-attack, and I expect Liverpool to be hitting Man United on their counter-attack to the counter-attack. I expect this to be an end-to-end. I mean, look at the results here over the last six. In the FA Cup in 24th of January 2021, 3-2 to Man United. In the Premier League, we've got 4-2 Liverpool, 5-0 Liverpool, 4-0 Liverpool. And then in a friendly this last year in July, ended 4-0 to Man United. And then in the league, it ended 2-1 to Man United. On the 22nd of August, I know Salah scored that evening. This was an evening game on Monday. Remember Sancho? Sancho scoring the opening goal with an assist from Alanga, and Rashford scoring from Anthony Martial, and it was Mohamed Salah scoring in the 81st minute. The team that day for Man United, we had De Gea in goal, Dalot, Varane, Martinez and Malacia, McTominay and Eriksen in the midfield, with Sancho, Fernandes and Alanga behind Marcus Rashford. Liverpool on that night were Robertson, Dyke, Gomez and Trent, Milner, Henderson and Elliott, and Diaz, Firmino and Salah. Well, the front three against Man United will be Jota, Nunes and Salah, I believe. I don't think Gakpo starts. I think that Jota, by all accounts, according to my work colleague that's a Liverpool fan, says that Jota has played really well across the last two fixtures. I do think that Jota brings a lot of life to Liverpool, and I do expect him to be starting against Liverpool, against Man United on Sunday. And like I say, I'm expecting that game to be a 3-2, and I'm going to go in the favour of Liverpool only because Man United have been playing so many games. But if it ended 3-2 to Man United, or with Man United win, I would not be shocked, because their momentum at the moment is ridiculous. We then come on to Brentford.